Hey, it's Fred Rambanis. I'm going to share with you a product from El Grande Lures. This is my signature bait with them. It's called the Boom Arang. What it is, it's a soft jerk bait. And here, that's what they look like in the pack. But it's a soft jerk bait that's a unique size. And what's nice about this bait is it's got a full belly body to it, similar to like a swim bait, but it's got the jerk shad tail where it allows it to dart in directions to trigger fish. So what's really nice about this bait is how versatile it can be. I mean, I do fish this mostly weightless. You can put it on the back of a swim jig, and like a bladed swim jig, and get extreme vibration out of it. But the way that I like to fish it, I'm going to share with you. This is a 6-aught Gamagatsu Superline hook. And the first thing I do with my Superline hooks when I'm rigging that bait is I actually take my pliers and I bend it out just a tad bit. Let's see here. Just want to bend it out. You want to make that offset just up a little bit above the shank for better hookup, really, more than anything. Rig it on 20-pound P-Line fluorocarbon, 100%. And if you go through the nose when you're rigging this bait, proper rigging of this bait is the difference between catching fish and not catching fish. So pay close attention. You come underneath the throat. There's a little V right there. You want to pop it right down to the top of the slot. Slide it all the way up. Cover your eyelet, cover your knot. You want to have pretty much just a straight line coming through right through the middle of the nose. That keeps it directional. Then what you're going to look back here is you're going to see the belly. And you're going to want to fold the bait almost kind of like in half like that and make it go straight into the bait and pop it out of the backside. So basically you're tex-posing it. Texas rig would basically be burying it. Exposing it's where you pop the point out a little bit. Now here's the trick. This is what I do is I actually will pull the bait forward, push the rubber forward, slide the point back in, and now I've got a little bit of a bend into the bait. That's why we call it the boomerang, similar to a boomerang that you would throw in and bring back. But you want to have that bend in it, and that's going to keep the bait diving downwards. If you don't bend it and you leave it flat, what's going to happen now is you're just going to kind of keep it on the surface, which is great if you're fishing extremely shallow water. But a lot of times, and the best way I like to fish it, kind of in that 2 to 6 foot zone, and I like to bend the tail and arch it down. And that's going to help dive it down and leave direction. When this bait sinks, weightless with 20-pound fluorocarbon, because of the density of the line and the super line of the hook, the weight, it's like the perfect combination. So remember, it's a 6-aught Gamagatsu super line, 20-pound, 100% fluorocarbon. When this bait falls, it's going to shimmy like a soft stick bait, like the El Grande Hatchmatch stick would. Check it out. El Grande Lures. This is the boomerang.